Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So on today's video, we're working on the GX470 today. I've got everything taken apart to do the water pump and timing belt service, but I wanted to do this side video kind of to detail the steps on changing the seals and the O-rings and everything for the oil cooler right here. So on today's video, we'll go ahead and go over all the steps for that and why you should do it. So stay tuned. So sometimes you'll develop a leak coming out of your oil cooler here on the GX470, and this is probably common for a lot of the V8s and then even some of the V6s that use this oil cooler. So this oil cooler has got a couple of O-rings. There's an O-ring and a seal behind the filter. There's one between the cooler and the mount back here, and then there's one to the actual block. We're gonna go ahead and change all three of those out today. So as you can see here, I've got the top coolant hose already disconnected because I'm doing the water pump job. But if you didn't have that disconnect, you could kind of do it without even removing those hoses if you do it under the car without taking everything off. But on today's video, we're gonna go ahead and just take everything off just to be easier. So the first thing we want to do is just go ahead and remove the filter. You're going to end up losing a lot of oil out of here that's still stuck in the filter. You don't need to drain your whole system because this thing is so high up that you just need to get the oil out of the filter and clean up anything that's inside the cooler or the tube. So one thing about the remover is you got to remember to unplug the sensor down here. There's a sensor and then there's a harness that plugs into that spot. You go ahead and just unplug that. So you saw my other videos when I was taking apart the head, this thing was poorly maintained by the old owner as far as oil changes. They either drove this thing very little due to the low mileage and the years, or they never changed their oil because this stuff was just caked on sludge. And you can see right there in the middle, that dark buildup right there, that's not normal. If you do regular oil changes, that center part should be the same color as the outer part, that bare aluminum. But this thing's got a coat of that crap all over the place. I'm gonna have to run some diesel in the oil after this just to clean this all up for a couple hundred miles because this stuff is just nasty. Even as I was watching some of this drip out of the old filter, all the little black pieces in there, that's just all that caked on old sludge that's been breaking off on the engine and the head on this recent oil change, and it's just all in the filter. So this thing's just nasty. So one of the things that I had to do with the water pump service was actually relocate and unbolt the AC compressor. But if you didn't have to do that and you were just under here doing this, you would have to take apart this bracket right here and this bolt along with the AC compressor bolt. It's 2 14 millimeters right there, and unbolt that. So we'll go ahead and just remove that right now to access the bolts for the actual oil cooler. And then in addition, I'm gonna go ahead and just take apart the coolant line right here on the lower part. There might be still some coolant in there that might leak out. Removing this little shield right here that diverts the oil might help too. I'm gonna go ahead and unbolt this thing to give me a little bit more room. All right, the next thing we need to do is take apart a nut, a bolt, and then a stud. The stud is a 14 millimeter, so those three kind of hold everything to the block, and then that should drop the whole thing down once we unbolt all three of them. So that's what the oil cooler bolts onto right there, that stud and those two bolt holes. Make sure we clean all that oil and everything up right there before we put all this back together. So here's the seals that we're gonna need for this oil cooler project. So this one is for the center bolt right here for the actual oil filter. This one is for the ring that attaches the mount to the cooler itself. And this right here is that figure eight that bolts to the block. So here we've got the oil cooler off. You can see that figure eight O-ring right there that goes to the block. That thing is pretty much flat from being on there all these years. So eventually this thing gets brittle and it doesn't seal anymore. So you're gonna get leaks there. In addition, you're gonna have possible leaks back here where the O-ring between the cooler and the actual mount goes. So that's another one. And then on that front one I showed you, it's right behind this nut right here. So we're gonna have to impact this thing off right here. Also right here, you can see that oil, that old oil buildup that I was talking about earlier from the old oil in this vehicle. That's just from poor maintenance and letting it sit too long. You can see that on the back side too, that just inside the tube, that oil stain, that brown stain that's in there, that's not normal for if you use synthetic oil that you change often. It does not turn like that. So this thing, it was using probably conventional oil and they let it sit around too long. So if you don't have an impact wrench, you want to be able to shoot this off on the vehicle. Since I have an impact gun right here, I'm gonna go ahead and shoot it off. It's a 30 millimeter right in the center. Just kind of put it in there. Just be careful how you hold it in case it thrusts back, and then just hit it a couple times with the impact. Once you do that, it comes right out. And then you can go ahead and clean all this up. I'm gonna go ahead, clean everything up, clean up all this old crap. Probably have to spray it down with some acetone and some solvents just to clean all this up. But on the back side, you can see that O-ring right there. That thing is pretty much flat on here also. So we'll go ahead and pop those O-rings off. Get one of the other picks in here. Yeah, this thing basically just broken off inside of here. So it's a good thing we address this now so we don't have to deal with it later. But yeah, this thing is just brittle as hell. I have to sit here and kind of pry it off. So even this O-ring right here on this backside, this thing is just basically baked onto there. It's not easily coming off, so I'm about to go soak this and get all this crap off before I peel that thing off. All right, what I thought was gonna be a quick change out ends up being taking forever. So that's that middle O-ring. It's supposed to look like this guy right here with the seal in the center. That thing is just completely deteriorated, just all gone. Basically all the rubber is just worn off over the years. Even the washer is like twice as flat as it should be. So obviously they must have changed the production on this or something to make it better, because that thing is just like, look at that. It's like freaking paper thin, where this one's like triple the thickness of that. So they obviously did make a change to this washer and improved it over the years, but yeah, definitely wasn't expecting that right there. As far as the rest of this, I'm just gonna let it soak in this super clean foam overnight and just deal with it in the morning, because this stuff is just way too much to deal with. It took me forever just to scrape that thing off. I just had projectile pieces of old rubber seal just fly all over the garage. So that thing is definitely needed to be changed, and I guarantee you there was a small leak from that, because there's no way that any of these seals would have held any of the oil in here. All right, we let this thing sit overnight with all this super clean on here, and it's pretty much soaked it all off, especially on this nut here that we saw yesterday. It was just covered. It just sat there and just eventually dissolved all the oil off. Inside the cooler and in here, it's pretty much dissolved off, so I gotta scrub all this clean. So once we do that, we'll go ahead and put everything back together. All right, we ended up cleaning everything up and took it outside, sprayed it down with a hose. I just let it dry, but pretty much cleaned everything out inside there. All that buildup that was in there is all clean. On these surfaces right here, since this is a mating surface, I'm gonna have to hit it up with a Scotch-Brite just to clean that up a little bit before we put it onto the block. That way the corrosion and oxidation doesn't spread on this over time. But the front side here, everything looks good. We're gonna go ahead and put the seals in. I'll let this thing dry for a little bit. I did heat it up with a heat gun just to make sure everything was dry on the inside. So I'll go ahead and that. And then here's all our seals we're gonna go ahead and put on there. The center thing that we had all covered earlier is spotless now. Everything's cleaned out inside and out. So this thing is nice and clean with all that super clean I've been using. Alright, we got everything cleaned up. Go ahead and start putting the seals on. Once we put the seals on, we want to get the bolts back on here. So these bolts right here, they're 14 millimeters and they're going to be 13 foot-pounds. This one little nut here that holds that bracket on for the AC compressor, that's 18. The center bolt right here that goes down the middle, that's I think 51 foot-pounds. So once we get it all up there, we're going to go ahead and torque it all down once we get it in the vehicle. Once we line up that O-ring on there pretty good, make sure you get the washer for this guy, slip it onto here, and then just tighten it down. And we just go ahead and thread this in by hand. And like I said, once I get it on there, we'll torque it to 51 foot-pounds. So after I scuffed it up with a little bit of the scuff pad, go ahead and get the figure eight O-ring into there. Again, lube it up, and then we'll go ahead and start bolting it down. One of the things I'm gonna do before I put it on there, I wanna wipe that surface with some acetone just to make sure everything's clean. So underneath here, we go ahead and just torque it to the 51 foot-pounds, and we're pretty much done with this. So I want to thank you guys for watching all the way to the end of this video on how to change the seals on your oil cooler. If you guys have any kind of mysterious leaks or any kind of leaks coming out of this thing, that's most likely the culprit, those three seals. Anyways, if you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you guys haven't subscribed to your channel, go ahead and subscribe to your channel. Remember, for all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.